Good morning, New Mexico Democrats. It's Governor Michelle Lujan Grisham, and I'm delighted to be with you this morning, although I really wish it was in person. I know we're all missing that aspect of building momentum in any campaign, but we're making a difference even though we're all doing our part to protect each other in this global pandemic. And for that, I personally want to thank each and every one of you for the work that you did in the primary to keep yourselves and New Mexico safe, and the work that you're going to continue to do by making sure that you're texting and phone banking. My job today, in addition to thanking you for your remarkable work, is to remind you about the impacts that you all have and the differences you've been making. The number of absentee ballots cast in this election, 1,000% increase, showing that no global pandemic is going to slow up the dedication, commitment, and effort of the Democratic Party. New Mexico for All is a movement, making sure that voters understand not just what's at stake in the state, but what's at stake in our country. In just a year and a half, New Mexico achieved raising the minimum wage, landmark environmental and renewable energy, working families tax credit increases, so the kind of tax reform that lift everyone up, a brand new early childhood education department with an early childhood education trust fund, and an effort well underway to provide universal free college to every New Mexico student. These are incredible achievements, even in a challenging budgetary time and a situation where not since the Great Depression have we seen this kind of economic and personal income insecurity. Democrats must and will prevail. We're going to have, for the first time ever and the only state, to have an all-women, and it will be an all-Democratic women, Democratic congressional delegation. It's incredible, with the first ever Native American woman representing a state whose multicultural roots create the foundation for fairness, equality, and making the kinds of differences that really will, in fact, alleviate poverty and the kinds of challenges that the state has struggled for decades. I couldn't be prouder of the state or prouder of our current delegation. And I don't want to forget that our next U.S. Senator, Assistant Speaker Ben Ray Lujan, he's going to create that kind of momentum for a Biden White House and a Democratic successful effort up and down the ballot. And as governor, I need this more than anything. I need to make sure that we return our House members and our Senate members. I need to make sure that the folks who got through their primaries are going to make it all the way to the general. We have to invest everything we've got, and we can't allow the fact that we can't campaign in person, and we can't build each other's enthusiasm by patting each other on the back, that virtually we can create the kind of recognition that today, with our racial unrest, the fact that we must combat institutional racism, that police brutality, that inequalities in education and healthcare, that they're only going to be addressed by making sure that we have another blue wave in 2020. Congratulations to all of us for everything we've accomplished. We can't let our foot off the gas now. Go out there and get them, and thank you for inviting me to participate. Thank you.